The Mountaineers, one of two teams tonight, desperate for a win as TCU comes to Morgantown to meet West Virginia. Green out of the post to the corner to Butler Lynn. He knocks it down. That's a three, and that ties the game. That those two players made back cuts as Anderson rattles home a three, if for no other reason than Bob Huggins was telling us earlier today for TCU. And an easy throw down for Jabari Hodge. Here comes Aaron Harris.
Yeah, for a team that struggles to score like TCU, their leading scorer has a green light to do that.
Eric Murray in the post, one-on-one. Able to score. Right over the top of Patrick McKinney. How so?
Just not excited. The guys on the bench are dead. The guys on the floor, no emotion.
Nice skip pass for a Hines triple. Nine different players have scored at least a point here in the first half for West Virginia. Kalichla throws it down. And that adds to the largest lead.
Colorado State, UNLV, they'd be able to hold their own in the Big 12. TCU was a middle to lower level Mountain West club trying to come into the Big 12 this year, so he has limited ball skills.
Brown, nice look to the corner. Wide open is Aaron Harris, and he makes it count. Another timeout called by Trent Johnson. Noreen, a sloppy pass. It finds Aaron Harris, though. Hines, left alone for three. Buckets for Jabari Hines.
Look at this TCU ball club. They have Baylor next at home. And they go to a struggling Texas ball club and then Kansas at home. So, interesting to see how they respond.
Nice look from Jabari Hines to Terry Henderson, and that's Henderson's first field goal. The Mountaineers break a three-game losing streak and bounce back after a lopsided loss on the road to Purdue on Saturday to win in convincing fashion tonight over TCU.